This is Sanjeev, and today I'm going to show you how to install Drupal 7. And if you face any issues on Drupal 7, we will be clearing out while installing it. So those who have not seen my videos on Drupal 6 installation and clean URLs, here are the links. Go to YouTube and just type Alien Coders. So you will get the first link as Drupal Basics for Beginners by Alien Coders, and this is the second video on clean URLs. So now we need to download and install Drupal 7 first. So go to drupal.org and then click on download it and extend, then download Drupal 7.14. come down. Either you can install in tar.gz if you are in Linux, or you can download in zip folder if you are in Windows. As I am in Windows, I am clicking on it, and you need to save the file. Already I have downloaded it, so now I am going to extract it with WinRAR. So once it will get extracted, I can just put it into our WAMP server and we can start installing it. The link you just need to install. This is the latest version, 7.14. Before that I had installed 7.12 in it, but to show you the real effect, I am installing it again as 7.4. So now we got it. We just need to copy it, and as you might have installed WAMP in your system, so that will be inside CWAMP by default, and we need to put it into www folder. So just pasting it. Till that time we can start our WAMP server. Okay, allow it. So you can see that WAMP server has been started. So just check if this is already working or not, either by clicking localhost or 127.0.0.1. So now Drupal 6 and Drupal 7.14 is there. Let's see. Once it will get copied properly, we can start installing it. Done. So let's rename it as Drupal 7. Go there, refresh it, and click on Drupal 7. Let's see what are the issues we will face and how the interaction is coming. Okay, so I clicked on Drupal 7 and we got the error, some memory issues problem. It's not like Drupal 6 where everything was coming, like choose install language and all these things. So how we can fix it? We need to increase the memory size. So for that we need to go to WAMP Apache and bin php.ini. so here we will see somewhere it will be memory limit, memory underscore limit. So see, it is 8 MB. You can increase up to 16 MB, 32 MB, whatever it is. Let's make it 32 MB, and as we have changed something in server side, so we need to restart the server before taking it effect. So restart the service. Okay, cancel it, minimize it. Now refresh it. I hope this memory error will not come again. Yes, so even before installing, it was checking like the Apache configuration is correct or not, at least for the memory limit, whatever it is required by Drupal 7. But in Drupal 6, it was not the case. In Drupal 6, it was coming under verify requirements, and it was just giving a warning, not like this, not a fatal error. But in Drupal 7, it is a fatal error. Now click on save and continue. So choose language. Okay, built-in is English, so let it be that only. We don't have any other choice also. Okay, so now the database configuration. Aha, it is showing SQLite, but I wanted to see MySQL here. How to do that? How to get another option, a radio button as MySQL? Because I don't know about this one, even I don't know that if this file exists or not, and what is there in that file. I am very much comfortable with MySQL, and it is very known to me, so I will go to that only. So how I can get that? For that, we need to go to again my php.ini, and we need to find somewhere pdo, and we need to find pdo underscore mysql. It we see it is commented, we just need to uncomment it. I hope after that mysql connection will get the mysql option, and as we have again changed something in server side, so we need to restart it. As I have restarted it, so we can now again refresh this page, see if that MySQL option is coming or not. Okay, so that MySQL option has not been yet shown, so we need to change something more. We need to find out PDO underscore MySQL, and we need to fix all. Let's check for PDO. Only MySQL is required. PDO dot SQL, it is there. PDO underscore MySQL, directly write that and check how many places it is, and it should not be there. Actually, it should come with MySQL option. And to find out why this is not coming with it. Oh, I did not save it actually. So now saved it, restart the server again, come to this page and refresh it again. Come on, yes, we got it. So now only we need to change the this one, so just uncomment it and refresh it. Before that, make the server ready again. So now go to database name, and before that we need to check that if database exists or not. So go to MySQL console and put the password and check if database is there or not. So I actually wanted to see Drupal 7. Drupal 7 is not there. No problem, we can create a database called Drupal 7 so that it will not show any error while writing that Drupal 7, mentioning that Drupal 7 here. Database username will be root, password whatever you have set for your database. We don't need to remember the password for this. So we saw two problems till now while installing. One was memory limit, so we checked it with the memory underscore limit under php.ini, and then we were not seeing that MySQL radio button, so for that we need to check pdo underscore MySQL. These two were the major problem, and settings.php problem was not here, maybe because Drupal 7 has already written so that it will override that default dot setting and it will start installing But in Drupal 6, that was also the issue. So now it is installing. It is showing something like Fedora. So like these many packages are there, and these many got completed with all this. What is going to be completed? See, block module. So we will explain this also, like what is the block module, what is color module, what is the use of color module, why it is in core package. So all those things we will discuss in another video. This is just about how to install Drupal 7 without facing any problem, or if you are facing any problem, how we can solve those problems. So once it will get clear, we can go ahead with all the basic definitions or basic terms on Drupal, either it is Drupal 6 or Drupal 7. So Drupal 6 is already up. I have already shown you those things. So this is already ready. So from the next time, I will show you the basic difference between Drupal 6 and Drupal 7 after installing. This is the first page when you just install and click on view site. So you will come to this page on default. So once it will get installed, we will see that what kind of page now it is showing. Is it showing something like this or some other page, some other theme? So after that we will check out what are the options under administration section. Install image module. List module. Most of the modules are now been included in the core package. In Drupal 6 these packages were not there, I guess. Anyways, it is nice. Now people are using Drupal 7 and Drupal 7.14 is the latest one. So it's fine. This clean URL video will actually solve the problem of that question mark Q equal to. So if you want something like this, suppose aliencoders.com, and you need something like, suppose you clicked on computer networks. And so it will come something like aliencoders.com category. So it seems like this, there is some folder called category, and inside that there is another one folder called, and it is not coming something like question and then Q equal to something like this. If you have not cleared your clean URL, it will come like this only. It's still going on. And see, I will click on request. So for this, clean URL is already saved. So after this, whatever modules and themes you need to install, first go into the main page of Drupal and click on either themes or modules, whatever you want. So you can directly click here, or you can write themes. So there are around 1,75,000 themes here. I mean, these are the search result, not themes actually. So there are themes around 1,000, and there are modules also. So now we will be using only the default theme which is already installed there. So after that we need to configure the site information. Let it be alien coders admin at aliencoders.com, that is fine. Username, let it be admin, and again email address, let it be admin at aliencoders.com, and the password, whatever you want. Default country. Okay, this option was not there in Drupal 6. These two options were also not in Drupal 6. So it seems Drupal 7 has added more features even while installing or setting up the configuration. I think we are just about to finish the Drupal 7 installation. We will see if it gets installed properly. Come on, come on, come on. Yes, so now visit your new site. Once after finishing Drupal 6, we clicked on visit our site and we came into this page. So in Drupal 7 it is coming like this. It is already, you are already logged in, but here you are not logged in. That's the nice thing with Drupal 7. See, all these things are already categorized in proper way. I think in Drupal 6 it was under only 4 or 5 categories, but here we can see the more categories, like for content different category, for structure different category. Earlier structure and configuration were in same category called site configuration, and appearance was coming into site building. So these few things are there we need to check. Admin and it's fine. Looks nice. Okay, so now we can log out, and in the next video I will show you what are these options and how we can configure this website similar to this one. How to get this blog, how to get drop down menus, and how to get this code here, how to put the logo here, everything. So thanks for visiting us, thanks for viewing the tutorial. If you want to see our another tutorial, you just need to type Alien Coders at YouTube. And if you like our website, you can like us in Facebook, you can subscribe into our email subscription form, and you can follow us in Twitter also, you can follow us in Google Plus also. Thank you all.